Everybody, thanks for checking out my video. This is number 4 in the series, Jazz Guitar with the Bell Tower. I am, of course, the Bell Tower. Today we'll be talking about the 251, which is a pretty tricky thing for aspiring jazz musicians. And we're going to give you some ideas about how to play over it, namely using some of the things we've gone over in previous lessons. And hopefully this will be a real easy approach to negotiating one of the most difficult chord progressions for young jazz musicians. So let's get started. Okay, here we are, lesson 4, talking about the 251. And in today's lesson, we're going to play a 251 in the key of C, which would include D minor 7, G7, C major 7. If you want to know where the numbers 251 come in, it's pretty simple explanation. It's just that we're building a chord off the second note of the scale in the key of C, that's D, a chord off the fifth note of the scale, that's G7, and then a chord off the first note of the scale. Anyway, if diatonic harmony is a mystery to you, there are tons of places you can go on the internet and read about that, and I suggest you do. Today we're going to talk a little bit about soloing over these chords or this chord progression, and I want to make it as simple and as easy as possible. So we're going to talk very briefly about a simple idea that we can use. We did talk in an earlier lesson about how D minor 7 and G7 are cut from the same fabric. And so if you spend some time just playing over this vamp or these two chords, what you'd realize is that the notes D, E, F, G, A, B, and C work perfectly for both of those chords, right? If you want to set up the Carlos Santana, right? You can play any of these, any of those notes, and that's going to sound great. Okay, so that works, over the last chord, C major, one very typical voicing for C major looks like this. And I'm showing you this chord voicing because if we take the root off that chord voicing, you've got an E minor triad right here. Okay? And that's where we're going to get our soloing material. Actually happens again here. It's another standard voicing for C major 7. And there's an E minor triad on the top. Okay, so we're going to play D minor to E minor. One more time. D minor, E minor. Okay, now I want to bring up one very important point that most jazz instruction books seem to overlook, and that is to look at this chord progression as just being in the key of C is wrong. Okay? Anybody who says, oh, you could just go ahead and solo in the key of C, you're not happening. Okay? The truth of the matter is that these two chords have an inherent tendency to resolve to C. Their state of being is what we call dominant. Play that chord progression over and over again in your quiet office, what you'll begin to hear is that this chord progression is not resolved. It's not done until we get here. Okay? If you're not hearing that, then what you need to do is spend some time playing this chord progression over and over and over again until you hear that stopping here sounds unresolved. Okay? That's a very important concept to understand if you're going to play jazz and solo. Jazz musicians do not solo and chase the chords around. Jazz musicians exploit the function of harmony when they solo. That's what allows us to play all those wrong notes, okay? So, when I'm playing over this chord progression, I'm playing D minor, D minor, E minor, but I'm also going to play chromatic approach notes from one key to the other. In other words, I might play some wrong notes right around the time of the resolution. For instance, I like to play this phrase. If this was our chord progression, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. Okay, let me show you that again. I'm improvising, so I might not play it exactly the same way every time. But essentially, the concept here is that I'm playing D minor. And then I'm walking a line chromatically up to a note that I know is in E minor and landing it on the downbeat of the measure that has the C major chord in it. Okay, very simple. D minor, E minor. Let's do that in a different position, okay? So what if we're playing the same chord progression, right? But maybe we have a D minor 7, right? There's D minor to E minor 7, okay? D minor, E minor. Let's turn that into a phrase. Here we go. Okay, let's try that again. Okay, that time I successfully completed that chromatic passage. Right? The nice thing about that idea is that we have a certain way of playing that phrase. Right? I think when I was improvising, it actually started like that. But we've got this idea, which looks like an F major triad, right? Or the top part of a D minor 7 chord, going up to an E minor 7 chord. Okay, and it really sounds like we're going somewhere. Right? Those wrong notes, I guess, is those wrong notes are accepted, or you forgive me for playing those because of the inherent tension that's built up in 2 and 5. And as long as I resolve that phrase properly to a note that is consonant to C major, all is forgiven. And it's people say, oh wow, look at that, man, that was really, you know, a hip idea. Well, it wasn't really that complicated. I played D minor, and then right before my resolution, right, I brought it up a half step and then up another half step, and this was the top part of my E minor chord, okay? Again, if you're uncomfortable with some of these positions that I'm playing, go to a position that is comfortable, okay? We could go all the way up to the 10th fret and play, right, D minor, up to E minor. Let's hear how that sounds. Quirky note at the end there. Anyway, so great concept. Just to recap, what we've done is we've taken the first two chords of the 2-5-1. We're playing one scale over them, right? The Dorian mode or whatever you want to call it, D minor. On the resolution is just that scale up a whole step, okay? You can get there by playing strictly scale-wise notes, or you could get there by playing some of those chromatic passing tones that I've given you today. Again, I really appreciate you checking out the lesson. If you have any questions, please feel free to go to www.belltowertrio.com. There's a link for an email there. Send the question. I'd be happy to answer it for you. Thanks again, and good luck.